Thanks, Ryan. Thanks for such an informative session on Xero. Hi, guys. Today, I just want to talk about use of data that we can extract from Xero and how we can analyze that data to drive some actionable insights from it. So just to give a little background about myself. So now I have been into data analytics from past 8 years now. And I've been working with clients across geographies, be it APAC, EMEA, or Americas. And every day from last 8 years, I've been hearing data as a buzzword, and the sound of it is increasing on a daily basis. I've seen clients talking about extracting the data, storing the data, transforming the data, managing the data. And once they have been able to achieve that, their next question is, okay, how can we use this data? And how can we visualize this data, analyze this data, and drive actionable insights? So this is where the business intelligence comes into the picture. And today, I just want to talk about different BI tools that are available in the market and how we have been able to use those different tools to connect with Xero and extract the data and drive some meaningful insights based on which our clients have been able to use the data and take some decisions on a daily basis. So in this webinar, just setting up the agenda, so I'll be talking primarily about two things: how we can extract the data from Xero and how we have been able to do this in the past and what we have been able to generate out of APIs that Xero is exposing for us. I would just like to share my screen now and take you through APIs that Xero has been exposing from last couple of years now. So as you can see, Xero has a pretty strong developer community, and what they have been doing a really good job of exposing all the reports that you see in Xero platform, be it a bank transaction, be it a manual journal or a P&L or a balance sheet or a cash flow. So they have been able to expose all these reports through web APIs, and any developer who can connect to these APIs can fetch the data, what is running in the Xero, and do some transformation on that data, make some customized reports, and then push that data into any of the BI tool, be it Power BI, Tableau, MicroStrategy, or any open source tools like Kibana. So this is how we have been able to use these Xero APIs in the past and help our customers in coming up with a customizable reports, group consolidated balance sheet or a group consolidated P&L or a cash flow on a monthly basis. So today I just want to show some of the reports, how we have been able to generate using these APIs. So for that, I'll just give you a brief idea how this process works. So as you see right now on the screen, this is an ETL tool what we used for extracting the API data from Xero and then pushing this data to a database and from that database to the BI tool at the end of the day. So first question that a lot of clients have is regarding the security of the data. If we are extracting this data from Xero, how secure it is? So Xero developer team has done a really good job of giving a multi-factor authentication through OAuth 2.0, where you have to have at least 2 point of security verification before you can fetch the data. So as you see right now on the screen, first you have to load a private key, and then you have to load a consumer key and a secret key that is generated through private app and some scripting that you have to do at the API level. And once you have that keys in place, then you are ready to go and call the Xero API and then fetch the data in form of a XML or a JSON file. So once this data is available to us, we can validate if we have got the relevant data for a particular month or a year or a quarter based on the business requirement. And once this data is available to us, we can parse this data, do some data transformations, exclude some irrelevant data, and have the clean data in a table format that we can push to a database where we will be doing all our logics of customizing a report. So now I'll just give you probably a live example how this looks at the end of the day, because some of people are really curious how this API really works at end of the day. So API is nothing but just a web link that allows you to hit to the Xero get the data in a XML format and then push the data to a BI tool at the end of the day. So as you see right now in front of me, this is an API that I have been able to extract for a bank transaction. So if I open here, this is a URL that Xero is giving to me, and this is a consumer key security step based on which I can extract the data in a highly secure manner. And then I just have to tell where I have to store my file. So this is just a simple process to give you an idea how a API works at the end of the day. And once I have this data available with me, just give you, So as you see right now on the screen, this is how the data comes for different months using an API. And once this data is available to me, I'll be just doing some transformations on this data and coming up with a table structure that I'll be using for creating customized reports. So this is just a bit of a technical background, how the API works. Now, probably I'll jump into the end results, how the data looks at the end of the day in a BI report. For this demo purposes, we have used Power BI as a BI tool on which we have been able to generate the data from Xero and create some Power BI reports. So I just wanted to talk about one of our clients with which we have been working from last 6 months and have been able to help him in coming up with a consolidated P&L, consolidated balance sheet, as well as cash flow statement. So the company had 4 different entities within the Xero, company A being the parent company, and then company B, C, D being the subsidiary companies. And at the end of the day, what they were trying to achieve is what I'll just gonna show through these reports that we have been able to derive for them. As you see on the screen, these are the individual profit and loss statement for the companies, and each company have their own reporting structure. There are different revenue streams for different companies, and they have set up this structure as you see on the screen right now in Power BI. Similarly, they have been able to set up this structure in Xero. And Xero does the brilliant job of doing this accounting at the end of the every month and giving them individual reports for each of the companies. But when it comes to having a consolidated P&L, this is where they want to consolidate revenue stream from all these three individual companies. This is where Power BI or any BI tool comes in handy, where you can extract the data using the APIs what I showed you, and then you are able to consolidate all these revenue streams into a format what group P&L or a group balance sheet would look like at the end of the day. So this is what you see. And then what flexibility it gives us is also it helps us to eliminate any intercompany transactions that any company might have on a day-to-day basis. So just to put in a different words, so Xero can give you an accounting report that you can use for auditing purposes. But if you want to have a true picture at the end of the day, how your company revenues look like by removing the intercompany transactions, this is how you can achieve using any of the BI tools, say Power BI in this case, and without any disturbance to the reports that are generated in a Xero. So this is where Power BI comes in handy, or Tableau or MicroStrategy comes in really handy. So, and this also gives you at the end of the day, all the high level KPIs, what a business is interested in. And these can be customized in a form how a business wants to see them at the end of the day. So as you see right now on the right side, this can be also presented in a form of a dashboard and give you a high level picture of how a business is doing at the end of the day. So just to give you a glimpse of how we were able to achieve this exercise for a client, that I am talking for this use case is what you see right now on the screen. This is where we were able to give him, okay, what was the closing balance for a particular month, or what was the cash in, or what were the ratios in terms of revenue growth versus last month, or high level KPIs, what a business want to see at the end of the day, what were the outstanding receivables or overdue receivables. So all these data can be presented in a graphical form, and it's really easy to read, understand the data and drive insights, because companies are generating the data on a daily basis, but they want to analyze this data, and bringing a BI tool into the picture make this journey really easy. So this is just a glimpse of a dashboard, how it looks. And the beauty of having a BI platform is you can consolidate data from any of the financial data sources as well as the non-financial data sources. Say a company has been using Xero for all the financial purposes. This is where they can integrate the data from Xero, as well as if they are using any other ERP platform for their stocking or inventory purposes. You can have multiple data sources and have reports in a single BI platform. So this is the beauty of bringing a BI tool, which helps in integration of various data sources and give you actionable insight in form of a graphical view. So that's where I just wanted to talk about use case that we have been able to deliver. I'll also just quickly go through a consolidated balance sheet for the same client that we were able to achieve using the Xero APIs. And this is what you see right now in front of your screen, is an individual company balance sheet, as you see, for company A, B, and C. And then we were able to have all the drill down functionalities, as you see, at a different category levels. If they have different bank accounts, how the balances look like. If they want to drill down for current liabilities, this is how they can do. And similarly for any of the super categories. So you get all the flexibility and customizations what a business is used to do at the end of the month, but in a really professional and a graphically illustrative way, which makes actionable insight come out to you. As you can see, okay, if I want to see, okay, what were my net assets at the end of the month, I can see in front of me in bold and highlighted. And similarly, we can come up with all the KPIs or ratios what a company is interested at the end of the day, without drilling down into any of the granular data available in the backend. Just giving you a glimpse how a final consolidated balance sheet for a particular company looked at the end of the day. So that's what we have been able to do. And now coming back to the main agenda of this entire webinar, to have a real-time cash flow. So Rehan gave you an overview how it can be achieved in Xero. And what we have been able to do is we have been able to come up with a template for a easy use of clients, which is right now in Excel. But at the end of the day, this would be a mechanism where this Excel would push the data to a database, and from database, this data would be pushed to a Power BI or any BI tool. So what I'll show you right now is an Excel template for a cash flow statement, where you can note all the receipts and payments that you have been doing on a daily basis, and you can write the forecast for the coming month. And once you have done these entries, you can see how it would look like in a final cash flow view in Power BI. So I'll just open one sample for you. So this is similar format to what you would find in a Xero platform, and it can be customized as per your needs. And this is what you see right now. These are the numbers that are coming from a Excel template. And however, as I said, this can be directly automated through APIs from Xero, and it can be refreshed. But for demo purposes, I'll just make some dummy entries for March, and I'll show you how these numbers would be refreshed and how you can forecast the opening and closing balance for, say, month of March. So let me do that right now. So I'll just go back to the template. Say I'm expecting a revenue stream of around 150,000 USD for the next month. I'll make that entry. Then I'll say my salaries would remain same for the coming month. Then I'll see, okay, these are my fixed charges. My insurance would also remain same for the coming month. And then so on, my interest payments as well as my loan payments. So once I have done all these entries for forecasting purposes, I'll just save these numbers. I'll go back to my Power BI. I'll refresh my data source. So once I have done the refresh, you can see the numbers are available right now here. And then I'll just go and publish this report on my Power BI server. So publishing this report to Power BI server means people in my organization who have access to this report, these numbers would be refreshed for them. And at the end of the day, at one click, this report would be published and floated to all the stakeholders in my organization who are using, say, P&L or a cash flow or a balance sheet on a daily basis. So once I have done this publishing, I'll just go back to my Power BI online service. I'll just go and refresh this. Yeah. And here you go, the updated numbers in the month of March. And now I can forecast what would be my opening and closing balance for the month of March just by changing the month. And this is how I can estimate. Okay, my opening balance would be around 136K, and after all the payments and receipts, this is what my closing balance would look like at the end of the month. So that's what I was just trying to show, how easy it is to use any BI tool and how intuitive it is to integrate with any of the ERP systems, or be it like a system like a Xero, which would be the brain for doing all the processing. And then a BI tool like Power BI, Tableau, or MicroStrategy would help in analyzing the data and doing some forecasting and prediction for your businesses. So this is what I just wanted to talk about in today's webinar. So yeah, that's it from my end. Over to you, Rehan.